السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh.
Lesson number 943. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised Hazrat Imran ibn Hussein radiyallahu anh regarding one aspect. But before we come to that, let us listen to a advice. You know, a relationship between two people is like a gentle bird that you have. If you squeeze it too hard, the bird is going to inevitably die. If you just hold it anyhow, just freely, that bird will fly away. But if you hold that bird with love, affection, and just appropriate hold on it, then you will have a pet for the rest of your life. Between husband and wife, children and parents, try and have a relationship which is very balanced, blessed with love, and inshallah relationships like that will be able to prosper. Hazrat Imran ibn Hussein radiallahu anhu was taught a dua by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But before we get there, let us listen to another dua. Anas radiallahu anhu says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, whoever has partaken of a meal, and after he partakes of the meal, he reads, Alhamdulillahi alladhi at'amani hadha at'am wa razaqani min ghayri hawlin minni wala quwwah. Then all his past and his future sins also will be forgiven. And whoever wears clothing and read the dua, Alhamdulillahi alladhi kasani hadha thawb ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة. Then his past as well as future sins are forgiven. So let's read the dua slowly. الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا الطعام ورزقني من غير حول مني ولا قوة. In the dua for the clothing, الحمد لله الذي كساني هذا الثوب ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة. All the past and the future sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven. Now we understand what the past sins mean, but what happens with the future sins is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide the person, that person will not go towards sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect such a person. Now we should try and make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability of making amal. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.